What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Kara here, registered dietitian. And if you are new here on this channel, we like to do all things food, nutrition, diet related, fitness. Did I say that? A little bit of everything here on this channel. Wanted to do a bit more of a fun video today, at least fun for myself, and go into my top 10 favorite foods I can't live without. So I know I do a lot of full days of eating, so you guys can view those as well, but I thought this would be a fun opportunity to kind of sum up my current faves, my must-haves that I can't live without, and also talk about some of the health benefits with them as well. I will say it was kind of hard when I sat down with a pen and paper to limit myself to only 10 foods because I'm just such a foodie. I'm also someone that, even though I don't necessarily get sick of food, like I just never eat the same thing every day, but I did kind of narrow it down to pretty much my 10 staples for the moment. Although I will say, you know, things change, so hit me up like 3 weeks from now and these may not be my staples as much anymore, but a lot of these are my tried and true. So just throwing that out there. We're gonna dive right in and just kind of talk about each of my top 10 faves. So my first one that's been like the OG of my life is avocados. And I eat them every day, hands down, unless I run out or they spoil and go bad. I am constantly eating avocados. Got my little avocado here that's ready to be ate. That is something that I typically throw in my lunch bag. I take it to work with me and I cut it in half and top it on anything I eat, whether it's a salad, whether it's just like a dish of like rice and protein and veggies. I love avocado on anything. And it's so creamy and delicious, in my opinion. But has many great health benefits as well. It's a great source of fiber, and avocados, interestingly enough, have more potassium than a banana, which when we typically think of needing potassium, we think of, I typically think of like bananas, potatoes, and tomatoes, but avocados are actually an excellent source of potassium. So for any of you guys who are active, working out, and need to replenish your electrolytes, that's also another good option. So for me, I can't live without avocados. It's just great on everything. My second one that I have been addicted to has been Japanese yams. And that, I'm being very specific right now. I'm just not talking any yam. It's a Japanese yam, which I do have one here to show you guys if you're not familiar. They can be a little bit difficult to find. I typically get these at the Asian market, but I do believe Whole Foods sells them as well. Those seem to be the only places I can find them. They do taste different than your standard yam. So depending on like the flesh of the yam, if you're talking about a regular yam or sweet potato, I know we use those words interchangeably, but this one has a white flesh on the inside of it. So the taste and the texture is a little bit different than your basic sweet potato or yam. Yams in general are very rich in nutrients. They're a great source of vitamin A. They're a great source of vitamin E, fiber. And I just love this one in particular because of the texture of it. And the taste to me is not as sweet as a normal yam, which I know it sounds weird because I have a major sweet tooth, but I don't know, I don't like my potatoes to be that sweet. This I find has like a nuttier texture, even though some may describe this sweeter. I find this has a nuttier taste to it, excuse me, like a bit firmer of a texture. So I'm obsessed with cutting these up, drizzling a little avocado oil on them and throwing them in the air fryer. Hands down, favorite like potato starch staple in my life for a couple months now. Favorite food number three is it has to be whole eggs. And I actually don't have these in any particular order, you guys, but I've been purchasing more pasteurized, cage-free eggs and doing a lot of whole eggs. I went so long with only eating egg whites, and you really miss out on the good nutrition that's in the egg yolk. And a whole egg itself is really such a great thing to add into your diet. Even if you're just eating one egg a day, a whole egg really contains almost all the nutrients. It's got so many different vitamins and minerals. You get some protein in there. it really does have so much nutrition encompassed in that little egg, the incredible egg, right? So I think it's a myth when people think dietitians say don't eat eggs or don't eat egg yolks. Absolutely not. Sure, if you're someone that's having high cholesterol issues, you probably should monitor your cholesterol and not eat 6 to 8 eggs a day, but having a couple whole eggs a day is extremely healthy for you and gives you great nutrition. I've been loving them more so for dinner time. I'll crave dinner when I come home from work and I'll make a couple whole eggs, and I've been loving them on top of an English muffin with like a really good salsa on top. That's kind of been my jam. Or on the weekends, I might eat that for breakfast, but during the work week, I tend to eat breakfast for dinner. Number 4 is squash, and I'm keeping this one very general because there's so many varieties of squash. And if you're like me, I used to think that I didn't like squash, but that was because I never really like dabbled into the squash family and learned the different squashes and how to cook them and what they taste great with. And this past year, I'd say Jason and I have both been obsessed with squash. One of my favorites happens to be the delicata squash. I love the delicata just because it's small, it's very simple to cut. Again, it tastes delicious, like roasted in the oven or in the air fryer. And that has just like a great consistency to it, almost like a French fry, but a little bit sweet. And so I love that combination of like sweet and savory, like topping it with a little pink salt, so delicious. And lately we've been doing a lot of butternut squash, and also recently tried kombucha, not the beverage. I don't know if I'm saying that squash right, but that was super tasty. It is very large, and squash again has so much nutrition to it, especially in the skin, which most squash it's tender enough once you cook it. Eat the skin, folks, because that's where a lot of your good nutrition lies. But I've just been really loving that with any meal that I have, just throwing some squash with a good protein and some veggies, avocado. That's my spot right there. Number 5 is new to my list, and that would be fresh mango that Jason recently bought for doing some product photos. And I knew I had mango, but I never really eat it or buy it. And I ate it and I was just addicted to it. And now I've been buying it like every other day. I've been going to the store and buying it. Well, I've been being lazy and buying the already cut, but I'm gonna get better because it's too expensive to do it that way. But it is just so juicy and delicious. I love it just eating it plain as something sweet, topping it in my yogurt. And the other thing I did the other day, which tasted amazing, was I made up a little salad with just spring mix and threw the mango in it. And it was just such a good combination. Just the mango and the spring mix alone was just like a nice, refreshing little addition to my dinner. So I've really been loving that. Not mad about it. It boasts tons of vitamin C, vitamin A, just good for your immune system, for your gut health, tons of good properties there. So I know it can get a little more expensive being a tropical fruit, but if you haven't tried mango, go for it. And I do feel like I'm not a snob when it comes to fresh versus canned or frozen. I think it's just better to eat fruits and vegetables in general, but the flavor is so much more robust when you eat a fresh mango. So highly recommend if that's not something that you've had in your routine lately. It's kind of a nice little refreshing change. This next one's not gonna surprise anybody, but that is going to be nut butter. And I love nuts as well. All of them. There isn't a nut I don't like, but nut butter is something that I have on hand, consume it in my diet pretty frequently. Lately, I've been obsessed with, this is just an organic peanut butter I got from BJ's that I really like, but I've been obsessed lately with just taking a banana and dipping it in peanut butter. That's been hitting the spot. It's just like a sweet snack if I want, or sometimes in the morning if I'm gonna go to the gym and I don't want something super heavy, a banana with a little bit of peanut butter always feels like just enough for me. It's just the right balance of like protein, carbs, and fat that I think fuel me for my workout without leaving me with that super heavy feeling where I'm like struggling to digest while I'm working out. Also, if you've never tried adding a tablespoon of peanut butter to your yogurt, that might sound weird, but I promise you it's delicious. Just stir it on in there. And of course, the good old peanut butter topped on your oatmeal, which I haven't been eating oatmeal as much lately, so I think that's why fruit has been my vehicle for my peanut butter. Next up is another tried and true, and that is just having on hand Greek yogurt. I eat Greek yogurt pretty much every day. On occasion, I switch up my varieties, but ever since I took a nutrition course where they discussed gut health and really looking at your yogurt and how many live active cultures are in there, I've been a bit more particular about what brands I purchase. So I pretty much switched over to Chobani, or I really like Siggy's as well. Siggy's tends to be a bit more expensive, but I love how thick it is. If you like a thick Greek yogurt, like we're talking real thick, go with Siggy's. But Chobani came out with this less sugar Chobani that has like nothing artificial added to it, which I appreciate. You do have to be careful with some of the artificial stuff and also the sugar in general that they add to it. I usually do like going for a lower sugar variety, or I do plain Greek yogurt on its own and either sweeten it with fruit or add peanut butter to it. But these happen to be really good, this Chobani less sugar. I love Greek yogurt. It's just like a good snack. And also, if you are someone that's counting macros, a lot of times if people are struggling to meet their protein goals and don't want to eat more meat, this is a nice alternative than eating meat. Obviously gives you a great source of calcium as well, in addition to the protein. Okay, number 8, I wanted to kind of choose my favorite protein, I guess, which is really hard for me because really I'm plain Jane when it comes to that, and I mostly go to organic chicken is usually what I have on hand because you can just dress it up so many ways. But for the sake of this video and my favorite, the number one thing I've been craving with protein has been fish. And fresh fish in particular, which gets really expensive. And we always do wild caught as well. I just believe it's healthier, it tastes better, and I just can't get enough of it. I could eat it every single day. But to save a little cashish, I picked up like a big thing of just frozen wild caught salmon, again from BJ's, which is just like a Costco if you don't know what that is. But those actually taste really good. I've air fried them as well. They work out really nicely. Again, such a great source of omega-3s and heart healthy fats, which are just great for your heart, great for your body, your joints, your brain health. There's so many great things there. So I really do try to have some type of fatty fish a couple times a week, but I could honestly probably eat it every single day. And I had failed to mention any real vegetables yet. Well, I guess like your squashes and stuff, but the one that I've been hooked on lately has been Brussels sprouts. But the thing with Brussels sprouts being super cruciferous, they can sometimes bother my stomach for how much I could eat of them or eat them every day. But Wegmans sells like a shaved down variety of them, which you could just do yourself, obviously. I just happen to be super lazy. But those go over very well in my stomach. I find I can digest them really easy, and they're just like my favorite vegetable. Drizzle a little oil on those babies, throw them in the oven, roast them. They're so, so good and flavorful. And again, tons of nutrition to them. High in vitamin K, which is great for our bone health and blood clotting, which is essential, as well as fiber and tons of other vitamins and minerals. So that one's a little nutritional powerhouse as well. And I love it. Goes great with any of my meals. And the last thing I wanted to mention, I've been really trying to be great about increasing my whole food consumption in 2019, but I also have to be honest with my lifestyle and how many things I have going on. I always need to have like a quick go-to staple. And lately this has been my breakfast every single day. Is the Outright Bar. If you guys haven't tried these, I highly recommend you do if you're someone that needs to have a go-to like myself. I really can't do protein bars anymore because they just hurt my stomach. I can't digest them. So when the Outright bar came out, that was awesome for me because it is just whole ingredients in there. It's like very basic stuff. Peanut butter, honey, MTS Nutrition Whey, you've got oats. This one has cranberries, white chocolate chips, and natural flavors. So it's very simple and there's none of the fake fibery stuff, nothing artificial in there that really hurts my stomach. And the macro ratio on it for me is perfect. 27 carbs, 11 fat, and 15 protein. So this has been my go-to for breakfast because I've been struggling on my work days to eat breakfast or take the time, not even take the time to make it. Honestly, it's just I haven't wanted to sit down and eat a big meal when I have to go to work and I've got so much going on. This helps me to make sure I get in a good source of nutrition and don't end up, you know, unnecessarily fasting myself for hours on hours, which I have no intention of doing. I do better when I'm, you know, kind of more routinely getting food in throughout the day, especially on a work day. So that has been my favorite. White chocolate cranberry is really good, but I really like the peanut butter chocolate chip as well. So that's gonna finish out my current top 10 favorite foods as of today. I hope you guys found this video kind of cool or maybe got some beneficial info from it, or maybe I inspired you to buy some fresh mango or Outright bars. Let me know in the comments below some of your current favorite foods you can't live without. I want to hear them below. And if you guys did enjoy this video, hit the thumbs up button. It really helps me out and the channel out. And we will see you guys in the next one.